What can you do every day to expose your children regularly to different languages without exhausting your family? In this video, I'm going to show you how to set tiny little goals for your multilingual kids so that over time, you reach your long-term goals. Hi there, Andrea here. Join me by subscribing to this channel and my mailing list. Here, you will find useful information, tips, and practical advice to raise your multilingual children successfully. In previous videos, we looked at how to set long-term and short-term goals for multilingual families. Now, it's time to break those goals even further down. This step is important because what you do or you don't do every single day will determine whether or not you will reach your bigger goals in the end. The author, Stefan Guise, I think it's pronounced like that, makes a good point when he talks in his book, Mini Habits, Smarter Habits, Bigger Results, about breaking down goals. He basically says that we should rather talk about habits than resolutions. Because unless we have concrete plans on how to reach our goals, resolutions stay nothing but empty words. So what are these tiny habits and how are they different from vague resolutions? Guise says that small habits help us implement something new into our lives without messing up our willpower. Interesting, no? Let me give you an example. A concrete resolution could be, every morning during breakfast, I read a book to my kids. That might work the first 2 days, but let's say your kids get sick and they don't sleep the whole night. Or even better, you had a party the night before. The truth is, you are exhausted the next day, right? What happens with your resolutions then? Well, the likelihood that you will end up dropping it is pretty high, don't you think? And once you realize that you haven't been able to keep up with your aim, exactly, you feel bad. Now let's look at what a tiny habit would sound like in this case. It would sound something like this. Every morning, I read one sentence to my kids. That won't even take you 5 seconds to read. The goal is so small that it almost sounds like a joke. It sounds easy. It's almost impossible to fail. On the other hand, things that make our plans likely to fail are tiring and hard. You should formulate your tiny habit in such a way that the effort is minimal. That way, you won't get exhausted and still will be able to start a good habit. A tiny habit helps you with the hardest task, which is to get started. Please hit that like button to support me and this channel. Thank you. What's more? Tiny habits strengthen your self-confidence because you are much more likely to succeed than if you have too high expectations and set yourself unachievable goals. Another benefit of tiny habits is that they don't require to turn your life upside down. You still have freedom to do what you want. That's important for your overall happiness. You don't want to be slaves of your multilingual goals, right? Once the tiny habit is well established, you can slowly build on top of that. One day you might even read a whole paragraph. Before you know it, you will be reading a whole book. But when life happens and things go crazy, you can still go back to one sentence. And the days that you manage to achieve more than your tiny habit, you will feel good about yourself. And that will fuel you with energy and motivation to keep on going. What do you think about tiny habits? Would you implement those in your family? Share your thoughts in the comments section and watch these other videos about goal setting. Thank you for watching this video called Tiny Goals for Passing on Languages, Goal Setting for Kids. Please share, like, and subscribe. Keep on doing a great job and see you next time. Bye bye.